Hi there, I'm Shirley Zane. I'm a director on the Sonoma County Water Agency Board, and we're here out in the middle of Colorado, about an hour from Denver, at a site that has developed the most state-of-the-art radar. We want to know when those atmospheric rivers hit so we can prepare our communities for floods. So we're taking this state-of-the-art X-band radar and we're bringing it back to California to protect the people who live there.
So AQPI is all about improving precipitation monitoring and forecasting in the San Francisco Bay Area, the whole nine county region. Where we're going to put new radars and some surface sites out in the Bay Area. There's going to be a total of 5 radar systems.
The type of radars that will be deployed, as I understand, is one C-band radar that is to look long range into the ocean, and then a network of X-band radars in the Bay Area, essentially to measure rainfall.
And then that information comes back to Boulder, where we're building the whole, what we call the AQPI system. So when we take the radar data together with the models themselves, we're going to get a better prediction of when and where flooding is going to occur. Instead of getting a forecast update every 6 hours, we want to get it every hour, maybe even less than that. We want to fill in gaps where the National Weather Service radar systems currently are either blocked or they just don't have a good view of what's happening over the urban environment.
I'm very, very excited about this project because this new technology will bring very accurate rainfall measurements. Not only that, it'll produce rainfall measurements at very high space-time resolution accuracy so that these can be fed into models to all sorts of applications to make decisions.
It's all about providing water managers and emergency managers and others the information that they need to deal with flooding, potential flooding impacts, and for water supply management as well. And our goal is to develop spin-off things like applications for your phone that can say, stay away from Route 101 between these two areas because we expect flooding in the next hour. So we see benefits here for transportation and other sectors of the economy as well.